All right, guys, welcome back. Today we're gonna be making a tulip art sculpture. I don't really know what to call it. It's a little tabletop, piece of art made look like a flower, heart. You'll see it at the end. to start off with the flower itself, I'm gonna cut one layer for the petals. I traced these out on a, from a paper template that I hand drew, as along with the two leaves that go with it. This is 16 gauge steel. Thicker steel than the flowers that we made, if you watched the other video, of the roses, which were 22 gauge steel. But these I'm not shaping by hand with a propane torch and pliers. So we'll shape this on the anvil mostly. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this out, and then we'll come back and we'll texture it and start off getting the stem together so that we can start shaping it. So let's go get it cut out. All right, guys, so tulip is all cut out. This is the basic blank for it. I went ahead and drilled the center hole while I was drilling the petals for the roses that I'm making, that are from the previous video. Something that I wanna mention is that I did take this to the belt sander, and after drilling the hole, there's a little burr here. So you wanna grind that off. And then from the bandsaw, there's like little sharp edges here, just little burrs. So I went ahead and grinded the edges of those off, and each of these points I rounded off. That way nobody stabs themselves with that sharp corner. What we're gonna do here real quick is use a cross peen hammer to texture this out, similar to the roses in the previous video where I used the chipping hammer. I'm gonna use a cross peen instead for this one. And we're only gonna do one side. We're gonna do it the, probably about 90% the length of each petal here. And again, we're gonna have it radius out from the center. So we'll do it this way. Just kind of gives it a nice texture there. And then we'll go ahead and start cold shaping this off, as it sits right here. I have done this in the forge. After welding the stem on here, I have gone ahead and placed it in the forge, and then did my shaping after it was hot. But now that I've got this larger forge and have kind of refined my process a little bit, I've realized that this 16 gauge steel cold forms just fine. It's actually easier to cold form it than it is to hot form it. Partially because now it's not on the stem and I can, use, my hands to hold the steel and really kind of move it around that way. So we'll start doing that right after I texture this. Additionally, we're gonna go ahead and texture and cold form the leaves. The texturing comes just from using a chisel here to essentially draw out the center veins, and then we'll just kind of give it a nice dome shape, curl the end a little bit, and that'll be it for those. So let's get that done. right, guys, hopefully you guys can hear me. There's a lot going on around here. Right now I got the forge going in there, so it's a bit loud, and then neighbor's mowing his lawn, so it's probably a lot of extra noise right now. But move the camera out here so that you guys can hear me over top of the forge. What we need to do next for this this tulip is it's accented by a heart right in the center of it. We're gonna make that heart out of a piece of 3/8 inch round by 14 inches. I'll need to taper both ends, drawing it out to roughly 16 inches. Don't mind my dog, there's a cat at my feet. It's a stray cat. He just kind of hangs out with me while I'm out here in the shop. But yeah, so draw it out. The whole thing will end up being roughly 16 inches. And then we'll curl the ends to make the tops of the heart, and then we'll bend it together, and that will create our heart shape. So let's go ahead and go back into the shop and get this into the forge. Thank you. All right, guys, so we've got our, sorry for the break there. There's a squirrel coming in here to say hello to me in my shop. So that's interesting. Yeah, hopefully he don't get too close. Anyways, so we have cut and pre-shaped our tulip petal. We've got our leaves shaped. We've got our heart shaped. I don't think you guys have seen what the final form of that looks like, but you'll see it here in a little bit when we get to the welding table. What we need to do now is create a stem. Now, each one of those hearts, every single time they come out, they are always just one's a little bit taller than the other and things like that. I usually make just one of these at a time. I don't do them in batches, so I don't usually have something else to compare it to make sure that there's, the same. So what I do is I start with a longer bar. This is a 3/8 inch bar. And I don't generally do anything else to this bar other than I will go to the bandsaw and about 3/4 inch, I will run the bandsaw around it just to kind of create a shoulder there. I don't want to cut all the way through. I just want to cut to about the diameter of the hole that we drilled through the tulip petals. The purpose for that is so that once you get that cut in there, you'll go to the bandsaw and you'll turn the rest of that down. I don't have a lathe, so that's the way I do it. You'll see what that looks like here in a minute. And that'll create just a little peg there. That peg will slide into the tulip bud, and then we'll just tack weld it on top. I prefer to weld. You can thread that, if you don't really have a welder. I don't really know how you're doing this project otherwise, but if you don't have a welder and maybe you're just wanting to make a tulip for some other purpose and not welding the leaves on and the heart and all of that, you can still make a tulip by putting the bud over that and having that threaded, and you can just thread a nut on there. I have done that before in the past for the roses that I make, and there's nothing wrong with it. I've threaded it and put a nut on there. I went ahead and tack welded the nut on there so that it would stay on and not loosen up, but I don't really understand. I don't see the point. I just tack weld each one of those, and that's works for me. But in this case, for this tulip, we're gonna go ahead and tack weld that on the top. And this being longer, what I'll do is after I get the heart welded onto the base, I can then measure to see, basically how tall I want it without having to, risk cutting this down and then realizing, oh, you know what, I'd rather have that just, a 1/2 inch taller or something like that. So let's go ahead and go to the bandsaw, cut that shoulder in there, and then we'll switch over to the belt grinder and turn the rest of that down. And we'll make our way over to the welding table and start welding it up. And From there, it's all assembly and final shaping. So I'll see you guys in a minute. All right, so we're ready to start doing a little bit of welding. One thing I forgot to mention was that when you do the rough shape on the tulip, you'll want the texture facing down. So all that hammer texture that you put in there, when you fold it up, will be on the outside. So same thing with these bends. You want it to bend with the texture on the outside. Turning down the little nub there, you don't need a lot. You might need a little bit more if you're gonna thread it and put a nut on there. I don't know, but you've only got the one layer of petals to put on, so you don't need a whole long nub there. All we're gonna do is just put that right inside there and tack weld the center. And then afterwards, we'll start closing this up. I'll probably do most of that cold and then throw out the forge, just kind of darken some of the metal there, soften it up so we can do some final shaping as far as making sure it's somewhat symmetrical. We'll flip these the tips out just a little bit, just to kind of give it more of a decorative look. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, guys, so to start shaping this tulip here, if you look at it, you'll notice that from the earlier shaping, I left every other one. So these three right here are higher than these three. So we're gonna take these three and push them in so that they come together. And those are gonna be the three petals that are on the inside. The other three will then get overlapped on top of those, forming the bud. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm gonna do that cold. Again, I have done this using the forge, and you know, over time I've just realized that it's not really necessary. Something that you do wanna pay attention to is that to do this, you can either use scrolling tongs, or I got these pliers out of like the dollar bin at Rural King or Tractor Supply or something like that. But what I did was I smoothed off the jaws on the inside using the belt grinder. If you don't smooth those off, then when you're, you know, tweaking on these, those little teeth in there will scratch up the outside of this and it just looks ugly. So whatever you're using to hold on to these pedals, make sure that they're smooth. Don't just come in here with regular pliers. So let's go ahead and start bending these up. And then if need be, we'll grab a little hammer here and just kind of find a spot where we can wedge in here. Just to kind of close those together just a little bit more. And occasionally what I'll do is I got these tongs here, and I'll just kind of bring these in here, shape this just a little bit. Just to kind of bring those together. And then we'll do the same thing for the ones on the outside. Just kind of move around, shape those together. Them tight. And then we'll take a look at it. All right, as you can see, the bottom of the bud here is twisted a little bit. So what we can do, see where that high spot is. I'll go in here. Kind of clamp it together and tweak it just a little bit. want to take a hammer and just kind of I'm hammering right here on these little corners here, just to kind of smash those in there just a little bit. May not look like you're doing much, but it's just enough. All right, I think that looks good. So now I'll go ahead and take my torch here. Standard propane torch. I'll just heat these the tips up here just a little bit. I'm getting a little low on the propane, so I don't think it's running very high. I need to get a new bottle. I'll probably end up doing this in the forge. At the end of all of this, I put this in the forge anyway, just to even out the color in the steel, darken it up a little bit, and then when I put the final finish on there, which is just a beeswax, looks real uniform. Alright, so see, we're just twisting that out there just a little bit. We're gonna do that to all of them. Ones on the inside. Take this and just kind of tweak that back together. And there we have it. That's our tulip. All right, so sorry about my dog. All right, so now that we've got the tulip shape, we've got the heart shaped, which is back here. So as you can see, we've got our little heart shape. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna weld this to a metal base. So we'll, in the front, we'll have the heart. Behind it, we'll have the tulip. Tulip will have two leaves on it. And then it'll be ready for the forge, just so we can even out the color in the metal. We'll heat it all up to just a red heat all over. pull it out, we'll let it cool down, and then I actually do the finish in the house, in my house oven. And all I'm gonna do for that is just heat the oven to 415 degrees, let the item sit in there for a few minutes, and then I'll pull it out and I'll melt some beeswax all over it. Just kind of clean it up. And a lot of the times is what I'll do is I'll put the whole thing right back in the oven and let it sit in there for another minute or so. It just kind of evens out all the wax and lets it melt down and settle, as opposed to like pooling up in some areas. But normally for the base, all the base is just a flat piece of steel. And normally I buy a quarter inch plate, but I'm all out of it. So I'm gonna have to look around the shop here. I'm sure I got some scrap quarter inch plate from some project or another laying around here. I don't wanna spend money and, you know, go and buy a new piece of steel. So I'm just gonna use some scrap steel. Highly recommend it if you can do that, because then you can maximize your profit using scrap steel. But yeah, so I'll just cut like a 2 inch by 3 inch base, and then we'll get to final assembly. I'll be back, guys. All right, guys, we're back here at the welding table. I mentioned earlier that this bottom plate was 2 inches by 3 inches. I was actually wrong. I don't know what I was thinking earlier. It is 3 inches by 4 inches. I drilled two holes, one, you know, about an inch from each edge, and then centered. This hole is big enough for this 3/8 inch bar. All right, so that's gonna slide right in there. The drill bit, I have no idea what size that drill bit is. It's not marked anymore. It is slightly larger than the 3/8 inch bar. It's one that I had laying around from a suppressor that I made a few years ago, but it does good work, and so I use it. Previously, I used to just put these on here and then I'd weld around the edges. I like drilling these holes out and then welding from the bottom instead. I just fill each hole in. I think it gives it a cleaner look. That way you're not actually seeing the weld around the edge. So I'm gonna start by welding the heart right here. I do that using this magnet here. There's my brush. I don't know how you guys clean these magnets off, but man, mine are always dirty. I found scraping them with this brush to be the most effective way. You guys know, particularly you welders out there, if you have trade tip there for me, that would be great. So I just place this on here. I let that ride the front edge, and then I just try to center that up so that it's level. I think that'll work. And then I'll come in here with my welder and weld that into place. You also want to make sure that it's not tilted this way, one way or the other. Can be kind of finicky. Sometimes I'll just come in here and check the height on both sides just to see that it's somewhat comparable. It's not going to be exact because these are slightly different diameters and, you know, all of that stuff. Not perfect bends, but I think that'll do just like that. So then, what I'll do is I'll tip that up in that place. I'm grabbing my welding helmet here. And left. This is where we determine how tall we want our rows. We do that by sliding this little thing inside here. And then just kind of eyeballing it. What do we think looks good? I think about right there will look good. So I'll put my chalk here. And I'll just make a mark. Run over, and I'll go ahead and cut that off. I'll probably do that on the angle grinder. So I'll be right back once I got this shortened down, and then we need to weld on the leaves before we weld it into the base. So I'll be right back. Up here, we got to put this on here, make sure it's all straight where we want it, and secure it with this magnet. Or maybe a different magnet, depending on how this is sitting on here. Make sure it's not crooked. I think that looks good like that. Make sure it's standing straight up and down. And then the hard part is getting this tipped over without that moving. Remember guys, if you can't weld, you can still grind. Terrible welds, but bottom of this has to get ground smooth anyways. So I'll go ahead and take care of that. And then after that's ground smooth, this whole thing will go back in the forge. What that's gonna do is even out the color of all the little things that have been heated up in weird ways. I'll go ahead and adjust these leaves a little bit, you know, and any final tweaks while it's still hot. And then I'll run a brush over it. I'll let it cool, and then it goes into the oven in the house. 415 degrees, preheat, and then I put it in there for about 5 or 10 minutes and let the whole thing heat soak for a little bit. Pull it out, and then I put a paste wax on it. I think it's made by Johnson's or something like that. But really, beeswax, some sort of canola oil, or you know, something to that, boiled linseed oil. There's lots of different things that you can surface finish metal with. So once it's up to about 415 degrees, I will coat it in that paste wax, and then I'll put it back in there and just kind of let the wax bake in a little bit for about 5 minutes, and then I take it back out, let it cool, wipe it all down, put it in a box, and ship it out. So once it's got the final wax on it, I'll come back, let you guys take a look, and have some final words for you. Other than that, let's get it finished up. All right, guys. So there we have it. There's the tulip. Heart shape in the front, bud on top, a couple of leaves, and then it's all welded to our base there. This one is sold, but if you would like to purchase one, you may do so from my Etsy store. It's linked down below in the description. If you got any questions or, you know, comments, suggestions, anything like that, then leave them in the comments and I'll be sure to answer them. Thanks for joining me, guys. See you next time.